API first and AI, of course, are the key topics here at Mobile World Congress in Barcelona. And I have the pleasure of talking to Colin Bannon. You're the CTO at BT Business. And maybe you can share your experience, what you've seen here so far in the first day at Mobile World Congress. What are the key opportunities? What are the key challenges for organizations?
Well, first of all, hi, Ronald. Nice to see you. It's an amazing place where many, many customers come, many, many vendors come, the policymakers come, and the largest vendors and the largest telcos sort of show their roadmap. Mm-hmm. I've had a little bit of time, maybe about 10 minutes between all the meetings today, to walk around and have a look at some of the booths. And I'd say my impression this year is, yes, they have a few things that they want to show that they sell today, but actually most of them are showing their roadmap for the future. So most of the sites that we're seeing is future innovation. What you can't see behind the camera right now is actual robots and flying airplanes and all the things that we're going to be seeing in our daily lives in the near future. And this is about the mobile and the fixed technology that will actually enable these things to actually happen. The business cases are being made right now, yeah. And it's really quite exciting. It's also a great time to meet up with other colleagues in the industry that we haven't seen for the year. Now we get to see them in the face, give them a hug, find out how they're doing, and start talking about shared challenges together.
Yeah, and you were talking about APIs,
yeah,
as one of the key challenges, the key opportunities that organizations have. Can you explain about it?
Yeah.
How it works, and why is it such an important trend?
Yeah. No, well, yeah, I mean, you got to take it at a couple of different levels, on the mobile level and the fixed level, and maybe I'll split it up into two things. But one of the things that we're looking at is making it easier for customers and partners, because it's all about ecosystems now. APIs are critical for partners to automate and reduce the complexity mm-hmm. of how you link with other partners and make them work. Mm-hmm. So that's really important. APIs also for sophisticated customers, that's a way for them to do and connect in and actually procure, learn, buy, get. But for telcos and service providers and partners, there's also a real pressure or interest to say, what do we do with all the data we're collecting mm-hmm. about our users, about the quality of our network? That information, how do we monetize that data? Mm-hmm. So more this year than ever before, you see the GSMA, you see partner alliances sitting down together to how do we create a set of common APIs between telcos and between vendors mm-hmm. that make it easy to start to push forward the first use cases for monetization yeah. of the data on the networks, but also things like dealing with fraud, dealing with SIM activation, dealing with network-to-network interconnections at the mobile level. So I would say that the mobile level right now, APIs are going well with things like the Camera Alliance, mm-hmm. where there's a large group, which BT is part of, and they're pushing forward the standards and also working with vendors to ensure that everybody works together and we have a common set of APIs and share the load on developing those. And that's the mobile level. Underneath that is the fixed networks. And that still, in many ways, is the Wild West. And there is a huge amount of opportunity there for BT. Mm-hmm. Our expression, we've designed our new global fabric, mm-hmm. which you've talked about
yeah,
before.
Sure.
That is an API first, network as a service.
Yeah.
So as you move towards how you consume things as a service, without necessarily lock-in, that is dynamic and real-time, mm-hmm. APIs are critical.
Yep.
And we designed our new network API first, particularly as the fabric, the global fabric which we designed, has 71 different customer-facing APIs to allow this concept of DevOps, so when customers are developing new applications themselves, they can reach in and just take the data that they need from the network, whether it be inventory, traffic flow, security, billing, the ability to spin up capacity, reduce capacity, connect to new clouds, create new opportunities, having a programmable network, it's essential to get your APIs ready and capable. So immense interest on that. So that APIs are really, really a hot topic right now. Yeah. But I'm sure you'll talk about AI as well.
As well, yeah, we talked about data, and then we automatically start talking about how to use the data, and you do it with the algorithms, AI.
Yeah.
What did you notice over here? What did you see in the 10 minutes that you walked around?
Well, as well as the future, I would say that first of all, it's very many of them said, well, we've always been doing AI, or we've been doing AI for 7 years. I'm the original gangster on AI. Yeah. So it's very interesting to see. And in a way, many of these vendors and partners have been doing ML, which is the precursor to AI. But what's probably new this year is a subset of the total class of AI, which is Gen AI. Yeah. And that's genuinely new. People haven't seen that. So, you know, there are some very big players in the market this year and a handful of hardware manufacturers. But based on what I'm seeing this year, there will be more hardware manufacturers that will power Gen AI next year than what we see in the market this year. So it's really quite exciting. And what we see from many of these booths right now is other companies' use cases for AI. Mm-hmm. And that's a really important time to see how different people are starting to develop their use cases to use AI to power to solve for problems that other people haven't thought about before. So that's really interesting to see how that comes on board. It's a really exciting time. But for me, as a network engineer, one of the biggest questions that I'm here to learn about is what is the impact of AI on the network?
Yeah.
And we know for sure that Gen AI generates a huge amount of traffic in the data center itself between the various nodes that are doing the training for the inference models that they're creating. What is really interesting right now is we are trying to predict what is the impact on the wide area network of Gen AI. And what we're seeing on the network, it's very early days right now, is that many partners who do software today have started linking to third parties that are doing AI to help them differentiate their software products. You're starting to see very interesting flows on the network where what was used to be a journey from the user to the app, now we're seeing it going out and coming back and going around. So really interesting idiosyncratic flows going on because of AI. And I think it's going to take this year and maybe in the next couple of years for us to fully understand the impact of how AI will drive impact to both the mobile network and the fixed network. It's an exciting time.
Yeah, it's an exciting time. And probably we're going to discuss this in Mobile World Congress 2025.
Yes, absolutely.
Colin, thanks a lot for all the updates.
Thank you.
For the most advanced and exciting trends here at Mobile World Congress 2025.
Thank you very much.
And for the audience, thank you for watching. I'm looking forward to seeing you next time.